a minute moving up on 10 o'clock. It's the Morning Joy program on Joy Gospel Radio FM. We're streaming out of Tortola in the beautiful, beautiful Virgin Islands. We're up on a hill. Yes, and you would have heard a lot of folks who've come here, or everybody who's come up on this hill, speak about the view. I had to rough up the person who brought my guest this morning. Because, you know, I told him that he had to be here for a quarter to 10. He was here for a quarter to 10, but I looked outside and he was just out there with his arms folded, just looking at my view. I had to say to him, listen, man, you have to pay for this view, you know. You came up here to do an interview. Bring the gentleman inside. Come on now. So, yes, we do have an awesome, awesome view up on top of this hill, and we just give God thanks for that. Those of you who are looking at us in studio, you would see that we have a gentleman who has joined us in the studio. He says, I ought to tell the folk about his name, James Bond. So all of the folks are coming together, James Bond, to wish you a great day, to thank you so much for coming on up to Joy Gospel Radio FM. We love having visitors. And I just want to welcome you, of course, to our studios. We're just about 2 years old. We're an internet radio station. We are operating, of course, yes, from atop the hill here on Tortola. And most of our listeners, as I was telling you earlier on, they're from the UK, from the US, from Canada, from throughout the Caribbean, and, of course, right here in the Virgin Islands. So we have a diverse group, mostly women, I must say, but we do have some men who listen as well, but the majority are women. So I just want to welcome you, and thanks to Brother Alvin Smith, a brother from my church, a disgusting brother to you, know, but he's all right, he's okay. He's Alvin Smith, who's the president of Prison Ministry, or Prison Fellowship, Prison Ministry, in the Seventh-day Adventist Church here in the Virgin Islands. And he contacted me the other day and said, listen, you know, we're celebrating or commemorating or observing Prison Ministry Week this week, and we have this fantastic guest who is coming in from St. Lucia. He has a remarkable testimony, and I would love to share it with as many people as possible. And I was like, sure, you know, I already had an interview set up, and so I had to postpone that to next week. And so here we are with James Bond. Welcome, my brother. Are you there? James Bond. Calling James Bond. Calling 007.
Yes, sir.
You're there?
Yes.
All right. There you are. So you just want to greet the family for us? I'm asking you to greet the family. You're not hearing in their headphones there?
Yes.
Maybe you need to take it off then if you're not hearing. Go ahead. I'm asking you to greet the family.
Yes,
for us.
Today I'm in Tortola and I'm happy because the Lord brought me here. So I'm sending greetings for my family down in St. Lucia. What that I'm happy to spread the gospel, to let somebody know what God has done for me. So I'm happy.
Okie dokie. So you are from St. Lucia. Tell us your correct name. Go ahead.
My real name is Alleyne Gabriel.
Alleyne Gabriel. But they call you James Bond. Tell us a little bit about
my soldiers name me 007 because of the actions.
Wow. Tell us about your life. Start from as far back as you can remember and tell us about your life.
Well, my mother brought me up in the Seventh-day Adventist Church as a little boy at the age of 3 years old. When I was 3 years old, she brought me up in the Seventh-day Adventist Church, and I left the church. When I started to grow at the age of 12 years, I left the church. And I chose the bad company, and I became the worst top class criminal that ever lived. Yeah. But to God be the glory, today I am a soldier for Jesus.
And you're talking about in St. Lucia. St. Lucia have bad boys?
They have criminals.
Wow.
They have shatters, gangsters, shooters, robbers, thieves, just name it.
So at what age did you leave the church, and tell us about some of the things that you did?
Well, I was going to church, but my mind wasn't in the church. My mother took me to the church, but my mind wasn't in the church. Because they have a lot of people, they are in the church, but they are not in Christ.
All right now. So tell us about when you started to stray then.
Well, at the age of around 14 years old.
And the bad companies. When you say bad companies, what do you mean? Running girls? What do you mean?
Well, running girls, that come after.
Okay.
But start thieving people things. You know, drinking rum, playing around, you know. Yeah, and I find myself in prison at the age of 16.
What?
Yeah.
For what?
For robberies.
What did you steal?
Well, gold.
Gold?
Yeah.
So like jewelry?
Jewelry, yeah.
But why? I mean, did you grow up in a home that
no,
you...
No, no.
Didn't your mother provide for you?
In life, you have to choose. Either you choose good or bad. And I choose the bad road, the rocky road.
But looking back, why did you do that, do you
well,
think?
Well, you're not in control of yourself. As long as you give the devil an inch, he will take a mile. And more you're getting worse. More and more you're getting worse.
So you ended up in prison at the age of 16
yeah.
years old. How long did you serve?
2 years.
Okay, so what was the experience? We're talking to an ex-convict here, guys. Listen, I pronounce Jesus over you there, brother.
To God be the glory.
I don't have any gold
Hallelujah.
Up in here, but I just cover you with the blood
yes,
of Jesus.
Yes, sir. I know that I'm covered under the blood of Jesus Christ.
Oh,
I know.
Praise the Lord. So, what was
God
that experience like for you in prison?
Well, falling in prison, I met my friends there. I had friends of mine that fallen before me. And when I met them, I seen prison bars, prison. Well, a prison officer told me, like, when you fall in prison, take out your mind. Put your mind inside of the prison. Don't you worry yourself about outside. Just leave your mind in prison. Because the body is in prison, so leave the mind in prison. And I started behaving bad inside of the prison cell. Until I started selling drugs inside of the prison cell.
Stop. Where you get drugs inside of prison?
Well, from the prison officers.
What?
Who have the answer? Only Christ that have the answer. Only Christ.
Lord.
Put your trust in Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah.
Yeah.
So you are shattered even in prison?
Even in prisons.
What
selling more
this?
Cocaine and more weed inside of the prison cell.
At 16 years
yeah.
old, you went to prison and it didn't change
no,
your...
No,
in
no.
any way. So did you get worse, do you think?
Worse. Because I made a vow with the devil inside of the prison cell.
Let's stick a pin right there. You made a vow with the devil.
With
now,
the devil to possess me.
Let's suppose we're talking to some folk out there who don't know what that means. Did you literally have a chat with Satan and say, listen,
yes.
I am yours? Tell
the
us
same
about
way that.
That
we not seen Christ, but we know Christ is alive. The same way the devil is alive. You can call upon him to possess you. And that is what I did.
But can you take us into your mind back then in terms of... What did you think that was going to profit you? How were you thinking to say, you know, I have a choice, God and Satan. I'm going to choose Satan. What did you say to him?
Well, I know because as I told you before, I brought up in the Seventh-day Adventist Church. My God said that if you're not for me, you're against me. So I cannot pray for the devil and pray for God. So you have to choose one. That is why Seventh-day Adventist people, my brothers and sisters, don't take your Christianity life for a joke. It is not a joke. Are you there? Either you there with God or either you against him.
Wow. And so in prison, you decided to sell drugs. Was this what? For money or just...
For money. Instead of prison, I have money. They have money.
So you were working.
Yeah.
So you served 2 years. And when you came out, what happened? I suppose you were a changed man by the time you came out at 80.
Change?
Change for the better.
I became worse.
Jeez.
I became a hired criminal now.
What does that mean, a hired criminal?
Well, relying on your phone to run for you to go and take out somebody for your money.
Take out?
Taking people's life for granted.
James Bond?
Yeah.
What do you mean, take out?
Shooting people, killing people.
Are you trying to tell me, James Bond, that you killed people in your life?
But of course, my sister.
Y'all pray for me up in here today, please.
Yes, sir, because it's getting hot.
Y'all pray for me.
But to God be the
Jesus.
Glory. Great things he has done.
Y'all pray for me up in here. And you're still in St. Lucia, right?
Yeah. I've been to England. Martinique was coming like a highway for I. The French country, yeah.
So somebody would call you and say to you, listen, there is this person that I need for
and
you
a
to
place, yeah.
take out.
Yeah.
And for a certain amount of money. Because you didn't do it for free, right?
Yeah, but if you was my friend, I could have do it for you for free.
What stupid is you saying?
But I'm telling you, that's why Christ loves real soldiers. No coward. That's why I'm willing to do anything and everything for Christ now.
Hallelujah.
Because he loves soldiers.
Hallelujah. And God Child in Shelton, Connecticut is agreeing with you. She says,
yeah.
God can change
yeah.
anything, even a shutter.
Yeah, I was the worst. Down in Alusha. I lose my brother in the battlefield and that did not change my mind. Whilst I was going to my brother's funeral, the police arrested me straight in prison again.
That was the second time?
Yes, second time.
For what?
It was involved in guns and stuff.
Okay.
Still robbery again.
And then you served how long now?
Around this time I got lucky because the judge had called 14 years for me. Mm-hmm. I was very good at it, do life for people. So I come out, I escaped that one.
Wow.
But all that time I believe the Lord was on my side.
Oh, absolutely,
yeah.
Absolutely.
Because they called 14 years for me and I did not spend all these years.
I'm telling you, Godchild, this is some crazy talk up in here.
Yeah,
I don't think that we've ever had such an interview here at Joy Gospel Radio FM, and this is one. I pray that it's being recorded. It's showing that it's being recorded. I'm recording it in two ways, and so, you know, this is one that is definitely going to go down in the history books. We have in the studios of Joy Gospel Radio FM an ex-shatter. An ex-convict, an ex-thief, a robber.
Yeah, just name it.
Everything that you can think about.
The devil supervisor.
The devil supervisor.
Yeah,
his people, his friends, his comrades called him James Bond.
007.
007, because you were the action man, they said?
Yeah.
Wow.
I wasn't a joker.
All right. So the second time you got away.
Yeah.
You got away, and then you said, all right. Didn't you say, well, okay, God is talking to me. I was blessed. I'm lucky to get away, so I'm going to change my life. I'm remembering my mother taking me to church, my mother praying for me, so I'm going to change my life. You must have this time.
No, I was getting deeper into the ocean.
So there's a question. There's a question in the chat room from Christine in Toronto, Canada. How did your mother take your lifestyle?
My sister? All my mother's hair fell out. All her teeth come out full stress. She could not believe. Up to the like today, she's walking on air because she's so happy. She's so happy. There is a great change in her son today. She see her prayers answered by God himself.
Hallelujah.
And I'm a chosen one by God himself.
Praise God. Well, we are so glad that your mother is still alive today.
To witness the change. Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
It's her testimony that we need to hear.
Yeah.
I'm telling you because, you know, God is so good, you know, with mothers. I mean, we heard a testimony some time ago from a lady called Glacier Robinson from Jamaica who was possessed with a mysterious illness for 5.5 years. Mm-hmm. And her mother is the one
there
who never gave up on her, who prayed for her, who took her from doctor to doctor. And here you are now saying that, listen, your mother raised you up in the Seventh-day Adventist Church, wants you to become a Christian, taught you the ways of God and everything. And you decided at the age of 14 that you want to be a bad man.
Yeah.
And here I was saying now that I wanted a son. You know, but I want a son, brother man. I mean, you want a son again.
Yeah, you could still have a son.
I know.
There is power in the blood of Jesus Christ, my sister.
That's true. Uh-huh. There's that turnaround. Mm-hmm. There's that turnaround. So your mother took it on really, really bad.
Yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm. So what was she saying to you? How was she speaking into
your life? When I was on my thing, my mother, I didn't want to hear my mother's voice. Because she wasn't seeing me. Having so much jewelry in my neck, my neck was full of gold and diamond rings on my finger. As a drugs dealer, you understand me? As a hired hitman, you know? I became a boss, you know?
So is it like you had people working for you?
I had my crew. I had my crew with me.
I could have just
stayed home and make a phone call and somebody would have lose their life.
This is mind-boggling for me. I've never really come so close to somebody who killed people.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Jesus. Y'all help me out here today, please. Jesus. Somebody's asking, ask him if he talked to the younger shutter about God. Those folk that you had with you in this criminal life. Have you gone back to them to talk to them?
That is my duty all about right now. That is why I am in Tortola, you know. In all ghettos that in Alleyne, I just ask everyone telling the soldiers about the love of Christ. I do work nowhere. I don't have a pay day. I don't have a job. I'm just working for Christ. And my soldiers kept on asking me, 007, how you surviving, boy? I telling them not by sight, you know, only by faith. You understand me? Yeah, and my soldiers, they are soldiers of mine. Some of them dead already. Even it was in December last year, they killed my cousin. in that same drugs business. And I told him to leave this life alone. Forget about it. And there is a man that can change you because he changed me. He can do the same for you. His name is Jesus Christ. He cleansed me from all unrighteousness. He took out the heart of stone I had and he gave me a heart of flesh.
Oh, praise God.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
He washed me in his blood. He cho-cho me. Yeah, he washed me, my sister. He touched me. I never see Jesus, but I just feel him.
Yes, yes.
I just feel the power of the Holy Spirit in my body.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow. Jesus, you're giving me
And listen to me.
Here.
Listen to me, my sister. In the year 2002, I got shot. It was my turn. I lent a soldier my machine gun and he shot me with it.
What?
He sprayed me.
Oh, how did that happen? Why?
I lent him the gun. I lent it to him. To gonna move. And he told me he lost it at sea. My gun and my bullet reverse. He told me he lost it at sea. And that wasn't true.
So listen, how did you were you incarcerated again after that 14 years old? When you were 14 years old and you went to jail that first time, did you ever go back to jail?
Yeah, I've been to prison up in Martinique.
Like how many times?
Well, they call 18 years for me. But I was very good at lying. As I told you,
Jesus.
I escaped it. I stayed up in, I spent 2 years in prison up in Martinique.
I suppose that was for the same thing,
never
possession
stopped.
Of guns and
never
ammunition
stopped.
And...
Never stopped.
Robbery and all of
never
that.
Never stopped.
So when you
I used to
people,
drink people's blood.
I'm sorry, excuse me?
I used to drink people's blood. I was possessed by the devil.
Not literally.
But I'm telling you, cut you and drink your blood.
Is somebody praying for me up in here, please? Mr. Smith, you come here, man. Let me see who bring, really... You come over here, let people see who bring this man into my place. You come all the way around here so that people can see. Because I'm recording this, all right? Uh-huh. So people need to see who brought this man into my place. I'm alone in the studio here today.
To God be the glory.
Listen,
the
you cover me. I believe in Jesus.
Yes,
I believe
sir.
In you. You see this man right here? His name is Alvin Smith, all right? He's my friend, but I don't know about after today, okay?
You bet me not gonna lose ya. Yes, sir. To God be the glory. Great things he has done.
Unbelievable.
He tell you he can change anybody that come to him. That's what my God say. And he changed me. I could not come out by myself. See me, I'm gone.
So listen, so you went to Martinique and you got in prison there as well. You were jailed there as well. That was the second time also. That was the third time.
Yeah.
So how many times you went to jail?
Around three times, but the police arrested me around 53 times. And I escaped in that.
Yeah. Lord Jesus.
Yeah, around that.
All right, hold on, folks. Let me drink some water. Hold on, I'm coming back, okay?
Yes, go ahead.
This is Joy Gospel Radio FM. We're streaming to you live from Tortola in the beautiful Virgin Islands. As I mentioned to you, well, you know that every Wednesday we do interviews, all right? And I mentioned to you that this brother from my church, the Seventh-day Adventist Church, told me that, listen, you know, he's the head of the prison ministry here in the Virgin Islands, and they're having prison ministry week. And there's this special guest that they have from St. And he has an amazing testimony that he wants to share with the world. He knows that I have a radio station, yada, yada, yada. I'm like, oh, sure, come on up, you know. And I was like, so what's the guy's name and what's his testimony about? And now I know why he didn't tell me what this testimony was about. Because you trust me, Angela would have said no. You know that, right? Lord, I love you. Lord, I know that you got me covered in all of that good stuff. But hello. Oh, Jesus. So we're talking to those of you who've just joined us. We're talking to Alan Gabriel. And he's better known to most of the folks in St. Lucia, where he's from, as James Bond or 007. And by that name, you would know that his testimony is involving guns and action and robbery and killing and just bad things. And we have live and in living color James Bond, 007, Alleyne Gabriel from St. Lucia. Sakafe.
Talking.
Yeah, that's as far as I could go, right?
I'm all right.
Yes, we're talking some Creole from St. Lucia. Yes,
sir. Muy bien, muela.
Yes. Oh, Lord have mercy. So we're saying peace and blessings to Sue in New York as well, who has joined us. Thank you very much. Godchild is saying that... she needs to hear your testimony. There's a prayer line that she's involved with that, you know, we'll talk about that after. And Wendy saying that I should calm down. But I tell you, Wendy, you could come sit in my chair, okay, and let me be on the other side. But I really and seriously want you guys to pray for us here in the studio. Amen. So listen to me, guys. So when did you find Jesus again? Because Jesus wasn't lost. He was always there.
Yeah.
When did you find him again? Or is there anything else you want to tell us before we come to that position? What else did you do? Lord have mercy. Help Jesus.
Well, my testimony, it have two sides. Because after I got shot in the year 2002, I was on that motorcycle. It was on a Sunday morning when I got shot. Man, this man burst 17 shots after me. Shots was passing through me like fire passing through a nylon. That's the time I lose my leg, my belly split in two with gunshot. You see? I'll make it see. Because I want it. Yeah.
Jesus, you want to show me?
My belly split in two with
from gunshots.
Yeah. I lose my limb. I have one leg.
I don't know if you want to show me these things, though. I mean,
yeah.
I believe you. Glory. I believe you.
I survive it because of Christ.
Hallelujah.
You see, in the middle of my tummy, I have a thread there. When I realize it at the hospital, when I revive from the gunshot, I see it there. I ask the doctor the reason why. What is the reason that I have, or what reason that I have that thread in the middle of my tummy? The doctor didn't want it to tell me. And when I kept on asking the doctor the reason why, he told me, well, that's my life. At any point in time, that thread burst. That's the end of me. Yeah. But at the hospital, that is where that I made a vow with the Lord.
In that hospital, when you realized...
I called upon Jesus in the shadow of death, yeah. You remember...
So what year was this?
My mother, she brought me up in the Seventh-day Adventist Church. She introduced me to Jesus Christ when I was a little boy. The first seed, she planted in there.
Yeah. All right, the guys want to see, the folks in the chat room want to see your belly. You want to show them? So you got to come over here behind me. Jesus, my head hot in.
They won't want to believe, they have to see.
My God. So, Jesus, and the lover of my soul.
See the leg too, you can see from there.
I'm not sure. Oh, what's that?
First leg.
Jesus.
I've got one leg.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
See?
Oh, my God.
That gunshot hit me. But to God be the glory, my sister.
Jesus.
Yeah. God be the glory. He saved me.
What's that?
But I go back and do the same thing like that.
After you came out?
Yeah.
Sit back down there for me, brother. Jesus, have mercy. God, help your daughter today.
That is why I cannot go for no
So,
more.
Okay, so we're in the hospital. We're in the hospital. Are you in St. Lucia? Are you in St. Lucia? Where were you in the hospital?
Yeah.
In St. Lucia?
Yeah.
Okay. So you were in the hospital in St. Lucia. You woke up and saw a thread in your stomach.
Yeah, in my tummy.
And the doctor said to you, that is keeping you alive.
Yeah.
And you decided there and then that you're going to turn your life over to Jesus.
Reason why I said to my God, if you have a purpose for me, if you have a purpose for me, lift me up from that hospital bed. I will accept you as my personal savior. And I will be a soldier for you. I'll go back into the same drugs. I will go back into the same ghetto after the drugs dealers for you, the gun dealers, the gun sellers, the gun controllers, the hitmen, the bad boys, because they know me. But if you see this is not important to you, put me to sleep into your name. When he shall come, he shall save thee as your son. I repent on the hospital bed there. You understand me? I repent from there.
I overstand you, star.
Yeah.
I overstand, yes.
Were you
ever a Rasta man?
No.
You weren't a Rasta man?
Nah.
All right.
But I have long plaits.
Okay. So how did you look? I mean, you're looking fine to me, you know. I mean, your face is shine, well, you're well shaven and all of that.
I know, I had a heart of stone. And the only change I know God has done for me right now, that he took out the heart of stone and he gave me a heart of flesh. He changed my mindset because I wasn't thinking right. I was mad for the devil, but today I am madder than mad for Christ.
Hallelujah.
That is why I'm in Tortola. Thank you, my brother, for sending me the ticket.
So I want to get to the point where you actually decided that, listen, I've had enough of this shatter lifestyle. I've had enough of this bad boy lifestyle. I'm going to remember my upbringing, and I'm going to yield to Jesus Christ. How did that happen?
My sister, when they, the doctor lose hope on me at the hospital. Remember the vow that I told you I make with the Lord? I made with the Lord at the hospital. Saying to the Lord, if you see it is necessary for you to lift me up from that hospital bed, I will accept you. I will go back after the drugs dealers for you, and I will tell them about you. And when doctors, everybody lose hope on me, imagine flies was taking me at the hospital. Ant was biting me, taking advantage on me. You understand me? And they released me. They discharged me from the hospital. I go back at my mother's place. At that time, I did not know house yet. Because
you
at the age of 23 years, I got
went back to your mother's house?
Yeah, at the age of 23 years.
You seriously went home
to
your mother's?
Yeah, that's what they take me, because I could not go. No, I was renting.
But then, I mean, all of this bad boy lifestyle, you never have no money.
Yeah, you just have money, you know.
So, I mean, you should have
no, renting. Bad boys doesn't stay one place.
Oh, excuse me, I didn't know.
Renting
that.
Cars?
Yes.
Because you cannot have a personal ride.
Oh.
You have to change your vehicle often.
Okay.
Because you can get wet in that.
Oh,
you can get shot in that. You understand me?
Yes, yes.
I used to make money like, whoa.
Wow.
You understand me? How much kilos of dope?
Jesus.
You understand me?
So we're talking not even marijuana, we're talking the
well, I didn't like marijuana. Too much big package and no money behind.
What is this?
I had rather the white powder.
Jesus.
The cocaine self, yeah. Check it.
Somebody pinch me, please.
I was sick for the devil. But today I am healing Jesus.
But you from St. Lucia, though? Them thing that happened in the Caribbean?
My sister, what are you talking about?
No, man.
My sister.
I mean, oh, Jesus.
Yeah, see so much fella that lose their life down here already. People die like woe down in Alusha already, you know.
I must be naive or something. I must be living in a different world or something.
Yeah. And my sister, when they discharged me from that hospital, when I made a vow with the Lord, a cousin of mine, he and his friend come and see me at my mother's place. But that day, my mother wasn't there. She was not there at all. The fellas tell me, 007, that's what these fellas did to you. Them fellas deserve to die. They have to die. After I make the vow with the Lord at the hospital. And guess what? I lying down there on the bed because I cannot move. I had a walker, but I shrink so much. Skins and bones. That was 12 people to give me blood at the hospital. Yeah, I had not no blood. Yeah. And whilst lying down at my mother's place, my soldiers come and check me. Soldiers tell me, 007 or shatter like you. Them man shooting you for your own gun, with your own gun, for your own thing, them man doing you that. Fellas tell me, I bring something for you. Yeah. Fellas tell me, I bring something for you. Guess what it was?
AK-47.
It was a 9.
Okay, I don't know what that is, man. I just know about AK-47 from the
AK,
news or something.
I had an AK-2. Listen, it was a 9. And fellas tell me, boy, they asked me, since when you bust a shot? Tell the fellas, I got shot in January. I tell the fellas, since in December I got shot. Last year. Because we're in January already. Let's tell me, Gasser, let me go. We put in you outside for you to go and bust a shot. After I made a vow with the Lord at the hospital. That was in 2002. And my sister, the fellas helped me to go out. They carry me to God because I can't walk. And the fellas give me the gun. Because remember, I was a gunslinger. Gun dealer, gun seller, gun controller, hitman, bad boy, rude boy, top shatter. And I crung the gun and I bust a shot. Don't never play with the devil. Continue saying no to the devil. And my sister, when I burst that shot, I felt a heat come back on my back. Like what I seen in my eyes is revenge. Revenge. I cannot wait for me to heal, for me to go back on the street to do more disaster.
This is after you done talked to the Lord and promised that, Lord, if you get me out of here,
I will accept you.
I mean, how many
but
times
when Christ say yes, no man can say no.
Oh, praise God. How many
Christ
times?
Christ never turn his back on us. We don't just turn our back on Christ. Because listen, to the reason why I can tell you that I am a chosen one by God himself, because he saved my life, I know that. And I could not come out in that business by myself, not by my power, not by my strength, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. He set me free. And my sister, I go back into the same thing, much harder. Now this time, no mercy for the merciless.
Yeah, because it's pure revenge now.
Yeah.
All right. So
but at that time, the Holy Spirit was haunting me down. Sometimes I used to have like a vision, somebody talking to me. Remember, you had made a vow with the Lord. You understand me? I open a restaurant, I run shit, I do shit. It's okay for me to say it like that.
Well, not really, but okay, we understand.
Because I'm coming straight to you.
Yeah, yes.
I will not curse, but I will, because I'm not cursing anymore.
Okay.
You understand me?
Yes.
And my sister, I live that life. And in the year 2013, I could not take it anymore.
Hallelujah.
When the Holy Spirit can arrest me. I had my girlfriend for 9 years. Because bad boys doesn't get married. 9 years we were living together. Without no marriage. Bad boys don't get married. Just now we die, you're getting married. For what you get married? You understand me?
Oh, Jesus.
And guess what? When the Holy Spirit come and arrest me, it was early in the morning.
Uh-huh.
I fly off from my bed. And I said to her, I will marry you. And the reason why I will marry you, because I will accept Christ. Goosebumps take her from head to toe. She could not believe. And from the time, my sister, I accept Jesus Christ, mm-hmm. I on fire for the Lord.
Praise
since
God.
In the year 2013.
I
on fire for the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I have been to all the ghettos after the drugs dealers.
Yes.
Into the highways, into the byways. Mm. And look, today I am abroad. I am
Hallelujah.
In abroad.
Hallelujah. Jesus, thank you, Lord. Thank
I am willing Lord. To stand up for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I'm only asking Christ to empower me and strengthen
yes.
me.
Yes.
And hold me with his mighty hands and cover me with his precious blood.
Hallelujah.
And I will press on for Jesus, Hallelujah. Not by my power. And up to a day like today, my soul just kept on asking me, 007 boy, how you managed to change?
Mm-hmm.
I am telling them it's not me, mm-hmm. but I call upon the name of Jesus Christ
Hallelujah.
And he set me free.
Thank you, Jesus. Now, let's go back to this girlfriend of yours.
Yes.
9 years.
Uh-huh.
She's living with this man who is a murderer.
A terrorist,
who is
yeah.
a terrorist, who rob and kill and steal. Tell us about this lady of yours. Tell us.
Well, my sister, what I can tell you, every bread have their cheese in it.
Tortola.
You can laugh. Every bread have their cheese.
Every bread have it cheese.
Yes.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Gotcha. You know we're talking about it. Yes, sir. Every
yeah.
bread have its cheese.
Uh-huh.
And so this sister got involved with you when you were a shutter or before you
shutter,
were?
Shutter. Shutter. Before.
So she liked that lifestyle. She was attracted to you.
Well, the thing is that because like they had something like a competition running long in Alusha. The higher shatter running things. You understand me? Respect for this man. Like, this is my wife. This is my girlfriend. Everybody have respect for that person because they know. You understand me? They know what time it is. Don't come and fool around. They know what time it is. You want to fool around by your casket.
So this girl was involved with you for 9 years before you actually got married. So
yeah.
Do you remember what year you guys met?
2004
she was involved with you.
And I got shot 2002, so I had got shot already. Before I met her, I had got shot already.
Okay. Now, what kind of lifestyle did you live as a shutter, as a bad man with a girlfriend? How bad man could love? You don't have no love in your heart. Did you beat up on her?
No. I ain't got no time for that.
You never beat up on her?
Before I lose my leg, I was running women. When I lose the leg, I start walking in women.
I don't understand that. I'm sorry. I'm a little naive here. So explain that to me, 007.
Before I lose the leg, I was running women, running a lot of women. You know, you understand that?
Okay.
Passing women like, whoa.
Yes.
Now, you know, when you lose your leg, you cannot run anymore. So I started walking in women because I get slow.
Lord have mercy.
So I didn't have one girlfriend.
Yes, sir.
Many. Because I was there like a king.
So then did you settle down with this one particular person?
Yes.
Or she was just there and you had other women
well,
on
she
the
was,
side?
She was living with me.
But you also had other women on the side?
Yeah.
But you never beat up on her?
No, I ain't got no time for that. Rude boys don't have time for that.
Somebody said Christine in Toronto asked if you beat her because she always imagined that bad man
No. Not that type of bad boy.
Not that type of bad boy.
Nah, man. I ain't got no time.
So what is it? You respected her? You loved her?
No love.
There was no love?
Nah.
Well, that means, man, how could
just
you be
such
a bad
living, reckless. You don't care. Because if you don't have love for yourself, for who you think will have love?
So why you had this woman living with you then?
Well,
she wanted to, I suppose.
But of course.
Ay, ay, ay.
You remember what I told you about the cheese and the bread?
Yes, sir. And Philip's.
Because
here.
sometimes when I'm busy, when I'm in Tongue and I have the restaurant, I tell her to take a gun and bring it for me in Tongue. And she put in the gun in her bag and she bring it for me.
Wow. Philip's here in the UK has joined us. She says, yes, every bread have its moldy cheese.
Yeah.
So she was actually helping you.
Well, you can say that, yeah, because she knows the vibe.
But she never got caught or jail or anything like that.
She wasn't too deep in it, you know?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Because I had take this kind of life just like my job. It was my job.
So she wasn't a church girl or anything, was she?
Yeah.
She was a church...
Mm-hmm.
She could be a church girl and get involved with your star.
Yeah, she's the one that told me that. She brought up in the church just like me.
She was a Seventh-day Adventist as well?
It's somebody that know God that can turn to the worst criminal, you know that? Because you know better and you're doing it on purpose.
Yeah. Wow.
Because you have a road, you have a master to choose.
Mm-hmm. Well, back to the question about beating up. You swear that
but
you
I'm
never
you,
beat
so
up this girl.
Why should I lie?
Because Sue in New York is saying some of these bad men actually do beat up on their partners because
them
they don't
abusers,
love them.
Them fellas is abusers.
Right.
But I wasn't an abuser. I wasn't. I got no time for that.
Ain't got no time for that. So she stuck it out with you for 9 years until you...
We got married. Jesus. She's my wife now.
She's your wife now. Do you have
children? We have a son together, yeah.
What are you saying? How old is your son?
4 years now.
He's 4 years now. So, wow, from shatter to lover man.
Yeah, man.
What? So you love her now?
Yeah, but now I have love in my heart.
No, you have love in your
because
heart.
Because I remember I told you my God took out the heart of stone and he gave me a heart of flesh.
Hallelujah. So I want to go back to when you actually decided that you were going to change your life. Tell us again about
well,
that.
I didn't plan it. God himself come and arrest me. Because I didn't plan it to say, yeah, I plan it. Well, next week, next month, I will accept Christ. No. When the Holy Spirit come and arrest me, I said to the pastor, if you know your life is not straight with God, don't try to baptize me. Because I have too much demons. I tell him that straight up. Yeah.
So he came to that place. Oh, he got you to
up to a day like today. That man is my friend. That man is my soldier self. That man is my soldier.
Soldiers for Christ.
Yeah, we are soldiers for Jesus.
For Jesus, hallelujah.
Yeah, man. Today I'm the one that telling them to hold on strong to Christ.
So this was back in 2013.
Yeah, in 2014, June 2014, I got baptized.
Got baptized.
I got married and I got baptized.
Hallelujah! In the Seventh-day Adventist Church.
Amen. To God be the glory. Why you in Pentecost? No, Seventh-day Adventist Church. Yeah, man.
So
we preach the truth.
Yes. All right. So I don't know if you want to go into that. I mean, we have people from all different denominations here who are listening. We do have some Seventh-day Adventists who are logged on as well. But somebody's asking me to ask you about your father. Where was your father?
Well, my father self. Well, the thing is that my father, he was a hunter, shooting wild boar, birds and stuff like that. And that is where we fall in love with the guns. As a little boy growing up, yeah, seen the guns there, but he'd never introduced us to the guns, you know, but I seen that there. I seen that is something I can get to like. But my father not into that kind of life. But he does drink. When he's drinking his rum color, quarreling with my mother. You see where I'm from? Yeah. So all these things that does mash up children.
Yes.
Mash up relationship and stuff like that.
But in all of your bad boy lifestyle, wasn't he able to be that father figure in your life to say, listen, man.
I used to give that man my gun to go and hide for me.
And he would
only
help
my
you.
Mother alone that wasn't supporting that at all.
Right. Because I suppose your family would have benefited from the money that you made as well.
Well, not really, because I wasn't. My mother wasn't seeing my face at all. You know.
Oh, she didn't. For years and years, you didn't allow your mother to see you.
No, she was on, but saying that she seen me every day, because each time she saw me, she's talking to me about live this kind of life alone.
Oh,
now
so
I didn't want to hear that.
You didn't want to see her, so you avoided her.
Yeah.
Okay. I got you. So, but your father wasn't one to say to you, listen, son, this is not the way to go, that kind of thing.
No.
So, do you have brothers and sisters and so on?
No sisters.
So, brothers?
Yeah.
Were they living the life that you were living?
Some of them, yeah.
Wow. And you mentioned that you had some family members who died as well.
Yeah, my cousin. I have his photo on my phone. I don't know if you would like to. You can put it on your...
Wow.
Thing.
Unbelievable. I don't know, guys. We're talking with Alan. Is it Alan or Alleyne?
Alleyne.
E-N?
A-L-L-E-Y-N-E.
Alleyne. Alleyne Gabriel. Uh-huh. He's out of St. Lucia in the Western Caribbean.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
my
Lord,
first cousin.
Have mercy. All right, guys. I'm going to show you a little gruesome picture here.
My first
here.
Cousin.
Oh, Jesus.
I talked to him. I tell him he was robbing together, killing together, shooting together.
Are y'all seeing that? This is.
I tell him to leave it alone.
Oh, Lord have mercy. This is one of 007's cousins who died at the hands of a gunman. Oh, Jesus. Are y'all seeing that? Do you want to see that, guys? Oh,
happened
Jesus.
In December last year.
December last year. And this happened in St. Lucia. What's his name?
No, in Martinique.
Oh, in Martinique.
And a drugs move.
What's his name?
Well, I used to call him Jack Shiwak, but his name is Mandela.
Oh, jeez. Mandela. Lord have mercy. Yes. So that's it right there. Do you have any pictures of you when you were...
at home.
At home, okay.
I don't have it on my phone.
You didn't bring those.
With gold on me and stuff like that. But
wow.
These pictures are not really...
You don't really carry them around.
No,
Twitter,
I ain't got
you don't want. Because you're a changed
yeah,
man.
Yeah, I got no time for that.
So is this the first mission outside of St. Lucia that you've done since you become a changed man?
Yes.
So what do you intend to do? What can the folks here in Tortola, in the British Virgin Islands, expect to hear from you? What's your mission?
Well,
here
who have else to let them hear?
So it's
everybody,
basically
I can
you
talk to everybody.
Sharing your testimony.
Everywhere, on the block, on the street, everywhere, by the roadside, everywhere. Just give me a mic.
Wow. Listen, we're so happy to have you up here. And you
I am so desperate to tell somebody about Jesus.
Lord.
Because remember I told you before I was mad for the devil, but today I'm madder than mad for Christ.
Hallelujah. And it's all about letting folks know that
to God be the glory.
God
Christ can change anybody that wants to be changed. When you come to him, he will never cast you out. He will change you. Seeing that what he did for me, the whole of St. Lucia can't believe, you know.
Yeah.
From end to end, people talking about that. There are people in Canada, Martinique, in France, everywhere talking about it. In America,
Have you seen anyone that you've lived that shatter lifestyle with come to Jesus, or you're the only one so far?
Well, I'm the only one so far.
So far.
But and most of my friends, they don't have no taste to press on anymore. They don't have the taste.
Okay, so you can see
the
eventually
change, yeah.
Where.
Uh-huh.
Your prayers will be
working
and everything.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Mostly all my friends telling me to pray for them.
Hallelujah.
Pray for them.
Jesus,
they want to come out and pray for them.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
So how does the world look on you right now? I mean, how do you get a passport, for example, to travel out of St. Lucia? What are you doing here? How did you get here?
Well, to God be the glory.
Hallelujah.
Great things he has done.
Yes. Wow.
Because what that happening today, not by my brother, not by you, not by me. It's by the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
It's through Christ all these things that is happening.
Because you're not using a false passport or anything, are
nope.
you?
Nope. Well, what? I repent, you know?
Yes. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Ah, what a remarkable testimony.
Yeah.
What a remarkable testimony.
Live that life, you know.
I want to give God thanks for you, my brother. I mean, this day, the 23rd day of March, will definitely go down in the history books of Joy Gospel Radio FM. A day when we hosted a convicted murderer, a robber, a thief.
God can change him.
A man who run drugs
and
ammunition. And we're just showing you a complete turnaround, a change. Yeah. That God has wrought in this man's life. Looking at him, you will never know. You will never know. He showed us his stomach, where his stomach was split in two from gunshots. Mm-hmm. He showed you his leg. Well, I don't know if you actually saw his leg, but I saw his leg and I actually touched it, and you saw me look, you know, I've never been so close to a prosthetic yet, and you know, so I saw it, and he knocked on it, and I can see that, you know, he said earlier that he lost his leg and so on, and I tell you, oh Lord Jesus, 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 I just want
to Christ
thank
have
you
me
so
for
much.
This purpose to thank go out to Jesus. Go and tell somebody about his love.
Thank you, Jesus.
And when he finished with me, my sister, he put me to sleep in his name, because they have done some passing blood, and I'm not worrying myself with that. My wife getting scared. Let us go to the hospital.
Currently, you mean?
Yeah.
Recently, you're just passing blood.
Yeah.
Because inside,
me,
you probably messed
mash up. Yeah. And my wife telling me, let us go to the hospital. Guess, hospital. My God is the greatest physician.
Hallelujah.
When he finishes with me, he will put me to sleep in his mighty name. I'm not afraid to go and sleep in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Why should I be?
Hallelujah.
On this day, my sister, no grave shall hold my body down.
Oh, Jesus.
No grave shall hold my body down.
Glory.
I will hear the song of the trumpet in my grave, because there is a connection. I am connected to Christ when he connect to me.
You know, I want you to talk to somebody who's been doing wrong all of their lives. You know, sin is sin.
Yeah.
And if you commit adultery, if you lie, if you steal, if you kill, sin is sin.
But you asked me a question a while ago.
Yes.
It's not really when you take a gun and you shot somebody, or you take a knife and you stab the person. You can be laughing with me and you hit me. That's murder. You can be in the church reading the Bible every day and they have a sister. You don't like the sister head or brother head. You're there killing the person. So you can be a criminal in your heart.
And so, do you have any remorse in your spirit about all those folks you have killed?
Well, I regret I lived a life, my sister. If I could have changed time.
Yes.
I would have never chose this road.
Right.
But Christ allowed it to happen.
Yeah.
Because he can take your mess and he can turn it to a message.
Hallelujah.
So that is why they had to talk to somebody trying to go into it or trying to engage themselves into it or in it.
Mm-hmm.
So I can talk to them. Because I just go into the schools and talk to the children in
St. Lucia.
Yeah.
Do you go into the prison, somebody's asking?
They never Well, the prison ministry down in my country, they never... I talked to them about it already, but they never...
They're probably still looking at you as this bad boy.
Not really, you know, but no. I believe more people, they're not interested into it like before. I'll put it like that.
Prison ministry is not as vibrant in
your
country as before.
Uh-huh.
Okay, all right. So, and then you as an individual, are you able to go into the prison on your own, or you would have to go through a particular...
I have to go through...
some organization or something.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you haven't been back to the prison in St. Lucia. Okay, so probably here in the Virgin Islands will be the first time you'll be. Well, I don't know if you'll be able to go into the prison here. I don't know what the plan is here. But you're saying that whatever opportunities arise, you are ready to let the world know.
Amen,
that
my sister.
No
amen.
Matter how deep you are in sin, God can change you.
To God be the glory. Great
he did it for me.
He can do the same for you.
Shatta, 007,
yeah.
James Bond, Alleyne, Gabriel,
criminal.
A hired criminal.
Yeah. He did it for me. The merciless, my sister.
And he can do it for you.
Yeah, I was a masked man. Yeah. My life was, I was sick in crime. I was lost in sin, but now I have been found.
Hallelujah.
I was blind, but now I see.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, Christ make me see.
Thank you, Jesus.
To God be the glory.
All right, we're going to wrap up now, and I don't know if you want to just whisper a word of prayer for the folks who have been listening on and encouraging you on, and there are folks out there who are steeped in sin. All of us are. You know, I have my issues as well.
Everybody.
We have our issues, and we just need to be encouraged by somebody today. So, you know, take some time and just talk to us. Preach, you know, just say, give us a word of encouragement, and you can end with prayer.
To God be the glory. Our Father which art is in heaven, thank you for this opportunity where that you had led me to come here, Father, to reach out to people that engage in sin. I am praying, Father, for them to call upon you, whether they will not harden up their heart, but they will open up their heart and they will accept you as their personal Savior. Because what you did for me, you can do the same for you. You can set anybody free who that come to you. You can set them free. Because you said that into your own words, whom the Son of Man set free is free indeed. And today, that is why I can feel myself. I am free. I don't need the 357 or the 38 special or the 45. Or the Beretta 17 shooter in my waist, or the AK, or the 12 gauge, or the 22, or the 25. I don't need it anymore, but I know that I am covered under the blood, O Lord Jesus. So I am praying for somebody out there, some drugs dealer, some gun dealer, some gun seller, somebody that engaging in this kind of life. I am telling them the devil is a liar, the devil is a trickster, and I am praying for somebody to go down on their knees and call upon you, and you shall set them free, because I am free in you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. This is my humble asking in the mighty name of Jesus Christ I ask. Amen.
Oh, amen, amen, amen. We want to thank you so much.
To God be the glory.
Oh, God. To God be the glory. To God be the glory.
There is joy. There is joy.
Blondie in Boston, Massachusetts says, great courage, my brother, to share your story. Glory be to God for changing your life.
Amen.
Please pray and ask God to strengthen you.
Hallelujah.
Because the enemy will be coming stronger after you now. And she's praying that some soul will be saved because of your testimony.
Yes, sir.
Jesus gave his life for sinners like Jesus gave his life for sinners like me and you.
Amen.
So that's from Blonde in Boston, Massachusetts. Thank you so much. Philipsia in London says, wow, such a testimony. May God continue to bless him and use him in ways that he cannot even imagine. Julie in Georgia says, may God continue to keep his hands upon him. Oh, glory to God. And Jan in Antigua and Barbuda was asking you, if you know a guy in Antigua called Sheffield Joseph. He was in prison in Antigua. Says he used to sell expensive watches and drugs. Sheffield Joseph, does that name ring a bell to you?
No.
Okay, no, Sister Jan. Wendy is from the Virgin Islands, but she's in Brooklyn, New York now, and she's saying, boy, she wish she was in the BVI right now just to meet you.
Yeah.
You know, but listen, he's here live and direct in the studios of Joy Gospel Radio FM, and we're just giving God thanks for this testimony today. To God be great things he has done. Family, thank you so much for allowing us to come into your lives, into your hearts today. I mean, I really did not expect this, you know, but I am sure that we were all encouraged and strengthened by this testimony here today from Brother Alleyne Gabriel out of St. Lucia in the Windward Islands. And he is, as he said to you, he was a shotter, a criminal, a murderer, a robber. And, you know, he just ran women and drugs and guns, all of that. And for years and years and years, he was involved in this kind of life. He was in prison for a couple of years, several times. But God, oh, glory to God, but God, he is here today, and he is determined that anywhere at all that he is called, he will be going in order to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ, that Jesus saves. Jesus can save you. Jesus can save me. And so if you're here in the Virgin Islands on Thursday night, he will be at the Purcell Seventh-day Adventist Church to share his testimony, and so you can interact live and direct with Brother James Bond here, Brother 007, Brother Alleyne Gabriel, and you can see his false leg. You can see him, you know, showing you his stomach, where his stomach was split into the scars from the life that he used to live. But we thank God. Thank God for the testimony. Final words from you as we wrap up, Brother Gabriel. Final words from you.
Well, a praying mother, don't give up on your children.
Ah, Jesus.
Continue praying for your children. Don't give up on your children, because Christ never gave up on us. So put down your knees and call upon Jesus, and he will do what he sees that is necessary for you. He will set your children free. He will set you free. He will, because I can guarantee you, he will. To change a man like me, no man could not do that for me. But it had to take a man. His name is Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
You see, when Jesus Christ found your newfound Christ, your life can never be the same again.
Hallelujah.
As a drug dealer that used to have money in his pocket, gold chain, gold ring, diamond rings on his finger, and today he don't have a salary. There are times I can barely buy groceries to put that behind me. Somebody that has given me some money to buy groceries or put fuel in my vehicle. There are times I just feel it because I ain't got a salary and I'm living by faith, not by sight.
Hallelujah. All right. Now, listen, if anybody who's listening and they want to get in contact with you to perhaps invite you to their country, is there a telephone number or email address? Or?
Well, my telephone number is 519-8680.
The area code for St. Lucia is what?
1758.
1758. Tell me the number again.
519-8680.
519-8680.
I'm available.
Okay, so that's 1758 519-8680.
Yeah, 80. 8680.
Okay, and that's
Alleyne.
Gabriel.
Yeah.
007.
Yeah, nickname.
James Bond.
Have mercy on my soul, Lord Father.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you so much for this privilege. We thank you, God, for your saving grace.
Yes.
We thank you for redemption, Jesus. We thank you that you can save us from the guttermost to the uppermost. Oh, Jesus, we thank you today for this testimony. We thank you for Brother Gabriel and for saving his soul and for the resolve that he has now to make sure that he can go back where he came from, to try and encourage those with whom he ran drugs with, those with whom he lived the criminal life with, to come to know you as Lord and Savior.
Amen.
We pray for him as he goes out day by day. Wherever he goes, God, we know that you will go before him. We pray that you will walk beside him, Jesus. Come behind him. Cover him, Jesus, with your precious blood. We pray even for his family, his wife, his son. We pray, dear God, that you'll continue to cover them. We know, dear God, that there are consequences for sin, and he has served time, and he has resolved now that the rest of his days he will be spent in your presence. He will spend it in your presence.
Amen.
And so, Father, we just thank you for this gentleman today. We thank you for this testimony. We thank you for everyone who logged on here today. We pray that we were all blessed and encouraged, knowing that no matter where we are in our spiritual journey, that God, you can save, you can deliver, you can bless, you can heal. We thank you for that. We pray that as we go through the rest of this day, that this testimony may go with us and that we can even use it to encourage others.
Amen.
We pray, dear God, for your continued watch, care, and blessing over all of us as your children. And we tell you thank you. In Jesus' name,
amen,
amen, amen.